Hi, and welcome to my guide. Today, we will be completing
every single free-to-play quest, excluding Dragon Slayer, in an optimal route on a fresh Ironman account. I wanted to make this guide because most of the current ones don't include the new quests like Below Ice Mountain, and they require you to buy all the items needed instead of procuring them yourself, though in some cases, like with iron ore or beads or redberry pies, it's actually easier that way. This is by no means a comprehensive guide for new players, but it should still suffice for most occasions. Before starting out, I tried to get as many levels as I could in Tutorial Island, which made things easier and a bit quicker later on. Sometimes I mess up the footage, so do as I say, not as I do. Once you've arrived in Lumbridge, if you're an Ironman, claim your armor for free defense later on. Using the drop trick, claim some runes from the Magic Tutor. Use up the runes you got from Tutorial Island on Confuse and train magic. We'll be mostly using only magic for this guide since it's faster. When training magic, remember that the dagger gives you mage bonus, while the wooden shield gives you defense bonus without impairing your casting. Make sure not to eat the bread since we'll need it later. Kill men and goblins until you have like 15 to 30 gold. Head inside the bar and talk to Veos to start X Marks the Spot. At the general store, buy a spade, shears, a hammer if you didn't get one from the goblins yet, some extra pots if you're feeling unlucky, and if you still have over 20 coins, buy 5 beers at the bar. You need 10 coins left, so if you don't have enough now, you'll be able to buy them later. Go south of the castle gate and dig in this spot for the clue. Head inside and talk to the cook to start cook's assistant. Take the pot from the kitchen table and go to the cellar. Take the boots, the knife, the bucket, and the cabbage. Fill up one bucket with water. Also, don't forget to dig outside the kitchen for the orb like I did. Go past the toll gates to Al-Kared. Head inside the palace and speak to Hassan to start Prince Ali Rescue. Outside the palace, talk to Spymaster Osman for your next step. Go and bank at the Al-Kared Bank. Take out your shears, an empty bucket, and 10 gold. Pass the toll gate and go north to the cow pens. Kill one cow for some raw meat and milk a cow with your bucket. Then, at the chicken pen nearby, pick up an egg. Go back south, cross the bridge, and enter the sheep pen. Shear 23 of them. Back at the castle, go to the dining hall next to the kitchen and burn the meat at the fireplace. Go to the second floor and spin the wool into balls. Talk to Duke Horatio and start the Rune Mysteries quest. Bank at the top of the castle. Take out 20 balls of wool, your milk, eggs, and as many pots as you have. Go to Farmer Fred and give him the wool to complete Sheep Shearer. Go behind his shack and pick up 5 onions. In the wheat field, pick up some wheat and mill at least 3 pots of flour, but preferably more. Walk back to the castle and give the 3 items to the cook to complete his quest. Bank again, take out your axe, tinderbox, fishing net, and pickaxe. You can also get a pickaxe on top of the castle gate and a net at the fishing tutor. Talk to Father Eric in the church and start the Restless Ghost. Go south of the graveyard, chop a log or two in the swamp along the way, and get to fishing. You'll want to get your cooking level up to at least level 10, so you better open up a new YouTube tab because this is gonna take a while. Just to give you an idea of how this is gonna go. Once you're sick and tired of fishing, guess what? Time to power mine. You'll need level 15, unless you have a better way to get iron ore, in which case you can skip this entirely. Dark's quest should give you enough levels to mine Blue-Rite.
And this!
What's he doing?
Is to go even further beyond!
Talk to Abigail to start Mystal and Mystery quest and get on the boat. Use a more in-depth guide if you don't know how to do it, but here's the main order of things. Scoop the rainwater to get the key to the mansion, read the first note and slash the landscape painting for the red key, light up the candles to dry out the room and light the fuse, leave, re-enter, head to the next cutscene, play the piano keys D-E-A-D in order to search it for the green key, go back for the next cutscene and read the note, use the knife on the fireplace, in the panel select sapphire, diamond, zenite, emerald, onyx, and ruby for the blue key. Time for your first boss fight. Reflect the knives 3 times and you're good. After leaving, talk to Mandy outside and complete the quest. Get back on the boat, head west of the swamp to Father Ernie's crab shack and get the ghost amulet. Walk back through the swamp, equip the amulet, talk to the ghost and ask him why the fuck he won't leave. Bank at the castle again, take your spade, orb, air talisman, and runes. Claim more free runes from the magic tutor, head off towards Drainer Village. On the way, kill a mugger or two for a rope. If you don't get one, you can buy one from Ned for 18 gold. Go to the Wizard's Tower's basement to deliver the talisman to Cedrador and receive a research package. Yoink the skull off the altar on your way out. Head north to Draenor Village to get this spot next to Leela and talk to her about the plans. Make sure to select every option. Start Vampire Slayer by talking to Morgan. Get the garlic from upstairs. Hop some worlds and buy a bunch of wines for food. Dig at the center of the pig pen for the ancient treasure. At the bank, take out the treasure, a bronze pickaxe, burnt meat, an onion, and at least 83 coins, and go to Port Sarum. Give away the treasure to Veos. Start Pirate's Treasure by talking to Redbeard.
There once was a man named Gold Roger, who was king of the pirates.
My fortune is yours for the taking, but you'll have to find it first. I left everything I own in one piece.
Yo!
Don't give it up, Lupe! Don't give it up, Zola! Don't give it up now, man! Don't give it up!
Give it up, give it up, give it up, give it up, give it up!
Yayo, 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 ho-ho! Set sail for One Piece! It's the name of the treasure in the Grand Line!
Yayo, yayo, set sail for One Piece!
Pick up a white apron from the fishing shop and get a job at the food store. Search the banana crate and get the rum back. Bring the rum to Redbeard Frank and get a chest key. Buy an Eye of Newt and a wizard hat from Betty. You'll only need 20 gold next, so you can spend the rest on runes. Head to the Rimington Mine and mine 2 iron, 5 copper, 1 tin, and 7 clay. In Rimington, start the Witch's Potion, kill a rat in the next door house for a rat's tail, and complete the quest by drinking the free soup from your school's lunch lady. Head to Falador. On the way, kill the Highwayman for your best in slot cape, and kill imps for beads. This is a good place to farm them since 3 of them spawn here, but it's annoying to kill them without more runes, so it could wait till later. This may take a while since beads are 1 in 25 drop rate each. In Falador Park, buy some woad leaves from Weiss and the Gardener for 20 GP. Near the west bank at the sink, make 1 soft clay. Bank everything, grab your defensive gear and a couple food. In the White Knight's Castle, talk to the Squire and start the Knight's Sword. Then head on over to the Stronghold of Security at the Barbarian Village. Now, I went north because they had Square Brain and forgot you need a bunch of quest points to start beneath the Ice Mountain. So an alternative route would be to go back to Draenor Village, make a key imprint with soft clay at the Draenor Jail, head over to Lumbridge, make a bronze bar at the furnace, go to Al-Karid, talk to Osman to make the key, then head to Lumbridge Cemetery and ask Count Check to teleport you to the stronghold. This would save you a walk of shame later on, but I ain't re-recording this footage, so just live with it. Go inside the stronghold and get your free 10k in boots. If you're lazy, you can just spam click through the doors, it's usually just as fast.
1, 2, 3, 4!
If you haven't died, leave the dungeon. You can buy a bronze med helm here, or pick one up for free at Drainer Manor later on. Head to Varrock West Bank. Pick up a beer, a bucket, a research package, the chest key, your money, magic combat gear, and some flour. You'll still need one left over after this, so don't use all of it. Go to the city square and buy a fire staff from Zeke, an iron chain body from Horvick, and go to Thessalia's clothes store and buy a pink skirt. Talk to Romeo to start Romeo and Juliet. Start the Demon Slayer quest by talking to Gypsy Eris and make sure to note down the incantation. Go inside the castle, talk to Surprisen about the Silverlight keys, go up the castle spire and talk to Captain Roven for the first key. Head down inside the library and talk to Reldo. Ask him about the Imkando dwarves and about the Shield of Arov quest. Find the blue booklet in the bookshelves and read it, then drop it if you want. Go inside the kitchen and pick up a pie dish. Make some pastry dough out of the flour and water, then fill up your bucket on the sink and flush down the second key in the drain. Head back to the square and ask Barrick about joining the Phoenix Gang. If you want to join the Black Arm Gang, talk to Charlie the Tramp instead. Head outside the castle walls and run east past the mages to the berry bushes. Pick up one cadaver berry and a bunch of red berries, you'll need at least 5. Make an uncooked red berry pie out of the pastry dough, pie dish, and red berries. Head back inside the city and talk to Aubrey. Give him the research package and buy some runes. Talk to him again to get the notes. Head inside the Phoenix hideout and ask to join. Then, head out to the Blue Moon Inn. There's plenty of imps around Varrock, so try to kill them if you don't have all your beads yet. You'll need some ashes later on as well, so get them from the imps if you don't have any yet. At the inn, kill Johnny the Beard and pick up the intel report. Talk to Dr. Harlow. Give him the beer, and he'll give you a steak. Head upstairs and use the chest key on the obvious chest, and read the pirate message. Go to the kitchen and cook the redberry pie over the range. If you burn it, try again. If you run out of supplies, shit man, just scrap the account and start over, I guess. Go back to the hideout. Give Straven the intel report and he'll give you a key. Head inside and search the chest in the back room for a shield half. Go outside and give your other account the key so they can get the other half. Yeah, that's right. If you don't have any friends, you'll have to do this twice. While your friend is getting the other shield half, go to the building north of the east bank and hit the combat dummies until you have 8 attack for some easy levels. Once you're both done, go to the Varrock Museum, speak to the curator Heg Halen, and swap over your 2 certificate halves. Go to the castle and speak to the king to complete the quest. Go talk to Juliet at her house and pick up the love letter. Bring it to Romeo, then head northeast. Go inside the sewer and pick up the second key from the western passage. Climb back out and go to the church to ask Father Lawrence about what to do. Go to the apothecary, give him the cadaver berries and he'll give you a potion. Give the potion to Juliet and talk to Romeo to complete the quest. Use the minigame teleport to Clan Wars to teleport to the Ferox Enclave in the wilderness. Bank all your items just in case, and go outside the enclave to pick up 2 iron bars from the item spawn northwest, next to the bears. Pick up 4 if you want your own blue-right sword. If you want, you can also pick up some planks from the graveyard for Dragon Slayer later on. Bank at the enclave, pick up your magic gear and runes, tin and copper, and the ghost skull. Teleport back to Lumbridge using the home teleport. Claim more free runes from the magic tutor. Hey, it's free money. Make a bronze bar at the furnace. Go to the cemetery and put the skull in the coffin to complete the quest. Now you'll need to collect 23 bones, so train up your magic to level 13 for Fire Blast on goblins.
Goblin Slayer.
Next, you're gonna have to get the rest of your beads and ashes from the imps. It should be easier now that you've got decent range damage. Once you're done hunting, go to the bank, equip a weapon, and for your inventory, take the research notes you got from Aubrey, 4 beads, and all the bones you have. Go to the Wizard Tower. Upstairs, give Wizard Mizgog his anal beads and he'll give you your best-in-slot necklace. Go down to the basement, kill a few chickens until you have 25 bones, don't fuck with the wizards, and give Cedrador the notes to complete rune mysteries. Go talk to Wizard Treyborn on the second floor, give him the bones and he'll give you the third key. Go to Draenor Village and buy some more wines for food if you ran out. Take out your magic gear, runes, food, steak, garlic, hammer, spade, soft clay, money, pickaxe, bronze bar, and redberry pie. Go to the Draenor Jail and talk to Lady Kelly to make a key imprint. Just make sure not to mention Katrine. Go to Draenor Manor and talk to Veronica to start Ernest the Chicken. Go inside and talk to Professor Odenstein. Go to the basement and complete your next boss fight. Following a more in-depth guide, get the fish food, poison, storeroom key, pressure gauge, rubber tube, and oil can. Talk to Odenstein again to complete Ernest the Chicken. On your way out of the mansion, pick up a bronze med helm if you don't have one yet. Use a Lumbridge home teleport and head to Alcarid. If you already made a key imprint before, go straight to Mudskipper Point instead. Talk to Osman and give him the bronze bar and key imprint. Go to Shantae Pass and threaten him to get sent to Port Sarum Jail. Break out of your cell and head south. Give the obese dwarf a pie and ask him about the sword. He'll need you to get him a picture of it. Go inside the dungeon on the hill nearby and mine a blue-right ore, or two if you want your own sword. After leaving the dungeon on your way to Draenor Village, talk to Captain Talk to start the Corsair Curse. At the Draenor Market, buy a chronicle and one teleport page from Diango. At the bank, take out 4 onions, 4 red berries, a pot of flour, a water bucket, ashes, 3 balls of wool, 2 woad leaves, 3 beer, a rope, a pink skirt, coins, and some emergency food. Talk to Ned and have him make a wig for you. If you don't have a rope, buy one from him now. Talk to Witch Aggie and have her make you 2 yellow dyes, a blue dye, a red dye, and some skin paste. Use a yellow dye on the wig and mix the red and yellow dye together to make orange dye. Talk to Leela to get the key and go through all the options again to make sure you didn't miss anything. Run past the aggressive guard inside the jail and give the guard inside 3 beers to get him drunk. Use a rope on Kelly to tie her up and shove her in the cupboard, then go inside the cell and help Prince Ali fulfill his dreams of becoming a convincing trap. After leaving the jail, go to the bank. Take out your orange and blue dye, a spade, the pirate message if you haven't read it yet, your combat runes, a chronicle, a beer, 2 iron, 4 copper, and 6 clay. Head north on the path between the Draenor Manor and Falador and walk to Willow to start beneath the Ice Mountain. Head south to Falador and head to the bar. Give a beer to Burnt Off the Dwarf and play some rock, paper, scissors with him to recruit him. Head inside the Falador Castle. On the west side, speak to Ceramic Vase to start the Black Knight's Fortress. Next, in the courtyard, talk to the squire about an image of the sword. Go to the east side of the castle and climb upstairs. While Survivin is in another room, open the cupboard and search it for a portrait. Go to the Falador Park and dig in this spot. After the farmer attacks you, you can either kill him or run from him, it doesn't really matter. Dig again and find One-Eyed Hector's treasure. Leave Falador and head northwest. Talk to Doric and give him the ores to complete Doric's quest on the spot. Go further north to the Goblin Village. Pick up 3 pieces of goblin armor from here, here, and here. Dye 1 orange and 1 blue. Talk to the goblin generals a few times to complete goblin diplomacy. Use the chronicle to teleport to Varrock. Talk to Charlie the Tramp and ask him about his brother Marley. Go into the Blue Moon Inn and ask the cook to teach you how to make a steak sandwich. Go to a bank and take out your best melee combat gear, the 3 silver light keys, and the best food you have. This fight is going to be tough if you haven't trained your melee stats much, but thanks to Vampire Slayer, your attack should be high enough that using the wines as food shouldn't be much of an issue. Go to the castle and speak to Surprisen to get Silverlight. Go to the Dark Wizard Ruins south of the city. Try to enter them from the south so you wouldn't have to deal with the wizards. Kill Delrith and seal him using the incantation you wrote down last time.
Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.
Bank again. Equip a bronze med helm, an iron chain body, some more defensive gear, take a knife, a pickaxe, a cabbage, a loaf of bread, and some food. Go west to the barbarian village. Talk to Chuckle, then go inside the long hall. Pick up the cooked meat on the table and use a knife on it to make a steak sandwich. Talk to Atlas to start your training montage. Talk to Chuckle again and flex on him to recruit him. Go north to the Edgeville Ruins and give Marley the sandwich to recruit him too. Head further west to the Ice Mountain. Go north to the Black Knight's Fortress, and if you have your guard disguise equipped, head inside. Push the wall and climb up the ladder. Navigate through the hamster maze and listen in on the dastardly plan at the grill. Go back the way you came, then enter the meeting hall and climb up the ladder. Push the wall at the end of the hallway and throw the cabbage down the hole. Exit the fortress and head over around the mountain on the other side to meet up with your crew and talk to Willow to start the cutscene. For this boss fight, you can try killing the golem if you're high level enough, or you can just mine the four pillars to crush it. Go to the bank, take out your iron bars and blue-right ore, the portrait, and some coins. Home teleport to Lumbridge, go to Al-Kharid past the gate, head inside the palace to speak to Hassan to complete Prince Ali rescue, then threaten Shanti again, get sent to Port Sarim jail one more time, break out, and head south. Talk to Thurgo and get the sword. Use a drop trick for him to make another one if you want. Go to Falador Castle, speak to Ceramic Vase to complete Black Knight's Fortress, and speak to the Squire to complete the Knight's Sword. At the bank, take out your mage gear, runes, and food. Have a couple inventory spaces left free. Head to the port west of Rimington and speak to Captain Tok to travel to Corsair Cove. Head to the southwestern building and pick up a spade along the way. Talk to Ithoy the Navigator.
Arr!
Talk to Gnocchi the Cook, Arson the Thief, and Cabin Boy Colin. Go to the captain to retrieve the ogre toothpick. Head to Ithoy's house and look through the telescope. Head to the fishing spot and dig here to find a clockwork doll. Climb down into the dungeon and talk to Chief Tess to return the toothpick. Talk to the crew again to tell them they're all delusional, and pick up the tinderbox near the cook. Walk back and forth from Captain Tok to Ithoy a couple of times, attempt to commit arson, talk to the captain again, and get ready for your last boss fight. Use your magic prayers. His max hit is 6, so eat food when you're at like 7 or 8 HP. After the wizard battle of the century, talk to the captain again to complete your quest. And congrats! That's it! You completed every free-to-play quest,
except Dragon Slayer,
on a fresh account. Yay!